Hey guys, Josh here from Sportitude. Today, coming at you with a kids' running shoe review. Now, back to school is only around the corner, and if a running shoe is on your radar to buy for your children, I'm going to give you as much information as possible to help you make the decision at home as easy as possible. So, without further ado, let's get stuck in. So today we're going to focus our running shoe review, or kids running shoe review, pardon me, on the ASICS story. Now, online on sportitude.com.au, we do carry a number of other options in the kids running category. So you've got some New Balance options. We've got a handful of Brooks shoes to pick from as well, just to name a couple of brands. But again, our ASICS sort of offering is a lot deeper and wider. So I suppose I'm going to give you some information more in line with the ASICS running shoe family for kids. So again, we're going to talk on the grade school offering and some preschool offerings and the difference between the two. However, just like adults, kids have different support categories as well, neutral and arch support. Now, just I want to point out the fact that I haven't picked up a shoe just yet, but running shoes are designed for running. Now, if your kid is really tough on their shoes and you're watching them rip through them in 4 weeks, 6 weeks, 8 weeks, consider buying them a cross trainer. Even if they do a lot of running, there are some running cross trainers out there that will give them a bit more support. Now, underneath this video, we'll put a link to our cross training video, which we've done recently as well, which will give you a similar sort of review to what I'm doing right now with the running shoe. So please remember at home, a running shoe is a running shoe. If your kid's gonna drag their foot on a court surface, play tennis, play netball, they're probably going to fall apart pretty quickly. So keep that in mind.
So I want to talk about the top of the line kids running shoe first, and then we'll work our way down. So top of the line ASICS running shoe is the Gel Kayano. Now this little guy here has jumped up in price. It's gone way up to $180 for a kids running shoe. That's RRP $180. Now the reason ASICS have done that is because this is a direct takedown of their adults Kayano, which retails for $260. So in the past, the Kayano kids hasn't been a Kayano. It's got the name on it, it's got the arch support, it's got very similar features to the adult's shoe. However, they've just given it the name to give it some entitlement in the kids' range. Now, this Kayano 24 is an adult's Kayano in a kid's package. So you've got your flight foam midsole, you've got your dual density gel cushioning system, heel and forefoot. Again, you've got your dynamic joy match under the arch, which is essentially between my fingers through here. So that's that arch support we're talking about. Underneath, you've got your Trustic system, which ASICS use obviously to split the rear foot from the forefoot to give the shoe some midfoot stability when you're running. Now, Meta clutch counter on the externally placed on the heel here as well for nice support for your children when they run. And up top, we've got your underlays, which gives that this shoe a little bit more medial support up top when the child is running and pronating off that through mid-starts phase. Now, I'll try and bring this close, and I'll just shimmy it side to side. So if you can see the sort of silver lining on that medial side through there. So again, I'll point it out as I come back. Essentially, that silver straps those underlays through there just to give the shoe a little, or the foot part of me, a little bit more support when it goes through mid-starts phase. So that's your Gel Kayano 24. Cool, so next shoe we're gonna talk about is the GT 2000. So still sticking with that arch support theme. So I've got your Joymax arch support on the medial side, just between my fingers through there. And I'll bring it close again, because I need to point this little feature out. So see on the medial side, it looks like someone's got a pen and just put all these dots underneath the arch through there. So I need to tell you, it's not a fault of the shoe, or not a fault in the manufacturing process. ASICS have done that to identify where the arch support sits. I have received phone calls from some people saying, someone's drawn on my shoes, or ASICS have got an issue with their manufacturer and their midsoles. It's not the case. It just identifies where the arch support sits. It's their way of splitting up the traditional EVA from the dual density EVA under the arch through there. So this little guy here, we've got dual density gel cushioning. We've got a gel pod underneath the heel, and we have a tiny little gel pod under what we call that first metatarsal joint, or your first big toe. So that just gives a little bit of cushioning on that toe face. We've got a shoe with plenty of flexibility, obviously through the forefoot, and a little Trustic system splitting the rear foot and the forefoot during that mid-starts phase of their running cycle. On the medial side through here, on the upper, you can see where my sort of above my fingers, We've got some overlays. So unlike the Kayana, which has an underlay, this little guy has an overlay setup, which is essentially a reinforced stitched piece of synthetic material to give the foot a little bit more stability through that mid-stance phase. We've got a nice internal heel canter for plenty of stability, which is great for running. And other than that, we've got a very breathable shoe. Lots of sort of breathability channels. We've got the forefoot, which is all mesh. We've got some channeling down the side and obviously a mesh tongue. So the running shoes are designed to be light, cushioned, and support the foot in a straight line motion and offer ventilation. So again, I'll touch on it. I need to. If your child is really rough in their shoes, please consider a running cross trainer. Hit the link below to the cross training video. So that's your GT2000. Next is your GT1000. So this little guy here is a little bit de-specced than the 2000. You still got a gel pod through the rear foot. There's just no specific gel cushioning through the forefoot. It's still got a nice EVA foam, which is gonna give you plenty of padding for little kids. Up top, we've got I'll go as far as saying this. This is the most durable mesh upper that the ASICS family provide with kids running shoes. It's almost like a canvas up top, so it's quite solid. There's no specific title or name for this knitted upper, and we've just noticed in store that it's a lot more tightly woven as such. I'll try again. It's going to be hard being a black shoe, bringing it close to the video. I'll get my black t-shirt out of the way, but if I just show it through there, it's just a really durable upper through and up top. Still obviously offers plenty of breathability, but nice and tough. Tiny little stitch toe cap at the front. On the medial side, again, we've got some arch support, the Duo Max arch support between my fingers there, or where you can see, looks like someone's got a pen and put all those dots through there to split the EVA from the arch. Gel pod again in the heel and nothing through the forefoot. We've got little trussing system splitting the rear foot and the forefoot, which is great. And other than that, it's a good little running shoe, that one. I mean, that's one of the better priced running shoes in the market for kids who are maybe thinking about getting involved in running. Reason being is at sort of $99 RRP, it's great value for money. Cool. So next on the radar is our Gel Cumulus, this little guy here. So ASICS Gel Cumulus is, unlike the other three we've talked about, it's on a neutral platform. The same density of foam the whole way around the shoe. There's no injected arch support in this little guy through here. So if you're sitting at home thinking, is that a bad thing for my child? Well, probably not. So as I touched on before, other than the Gel Cano, which is a complete takedown from their adults, the 2000 and then the 1000 are de-spec versions of the adult. So yes, they have some arch support, but it's sort of been generically placed under the midsection through here. So kids, again, they've got growing feet. So you've got a kid with ligaments and bones all redeveloping all the time. So some kids have rapid growth spurts, some take a little bit longer. Girls' feet tend to develop a lot faster than boys. But that being said, so with a kid's foot that's ever growing all the time, if you go and put in a specific arch support in an area, it's doing a bit of a general job. When we talk about adults running shoes, we've stopped growing, of course, then that support can be really targeted into the right area. Guidance, stability, midfoot stability, neutral stability, and obviously forefoot toe off pronation support. So they've got a lot more variety in the adults range, of course. Kids is a bit generic. So getting back to the Cumulus. So again, neutral platform. We've got a shoe with a gel pod through the heel, and we've got a tiny little gel pod through the forefoot. Now, one thing I do like about this shoe, I'll bring it closer. So just underneath my finger here, you can see how the outsole, the pink outsole, the flex groove doesn't go from the lateral side to the medial side. It actually is encapsulated underneath that toe off phase. So although they don't have arch support, the shoe is a little bit more rigid underneath that toe off phase to give your child a little bit more support as they toe off, which is a good thing. You don't want to completely drop off that first metatarsal joint. So we've got a nice deep heel counter. If your child has orthotics, and whether they be full length orthotics or little half orthotics, this shoe is an easy one to fit because it's so structured, so deep at the back and nice and stable. The insert does come out, and that's the same thing with all the other options we've talked about today. The inserts come out easily as well. So if you're a podiatrist that may want to put an orthotic inside a shoe, you can do. Another feature I like about this shoe is it's got a really breathable upper, but however, it's actually relatively supported with these overlayers as well. ASICS have done a good job to give plenty of freedom through the mesh upper, however, give it some structure and support up top with those overlayers. So next feature I'd like to talk about is the outsole. So you can see here underneath this, what they call the guidance line in their running shoes. They've actually shifted this ever so slightly to the lateral side. So being for a more of a neutral foot type, like your adults family, if you look at the guidance lines like the Nimbus and the Cumulus in the adults family, they do just push this guidance line sort of more towards the middle of the foot. When you look at the GT2000 adults, GT1000 adults, and then you look at the Kayano 3 here, you can see how that guidance line, or the vertical guidance line that we're talking about, the one that runs from the heel to the forefoot, how it's pushed more to the lateral side through here. That's essentially done so you can give the foot a little bit more outsole support on toe off through here, not only just relying on the arch. So that is your Gel Cumulus Kids running shoe. Now, there is also a Gel Nimbus Kids running shoe at the moment. We just haven't received our stock, but that is coming very, very soon. We'll be up online to purchase for you guys. That's essentially a shoe that's got a little bit more cushioning than this guy here, just on the same neutral platform. Cool. So there you have it. That is a bit of a sneak peek of the performance ASICS running story. Now, there are some other ASICS running shoes which sit just underneath this. Just again, de-specced ever so slightly. One that springs to mind is your Gel Contend 4, which has essentially got an EVA foam, relatively solid upper on top, but I wouldn't say it's a shoe that if your kid's doing a lot of running, I wouldn't consider. It's a shoe that I consider if they're maybe getting involved in a little bit of little athletics or wanting to do a bit of running, just sort of dip their toe in the water, see if they like it. This family I've touched on here is for your child that really enjoys the running, loves going out for a little gallop. That's the shoe, or this is essentially some of the shoes you should consider. Cool, there we go. That's your running family.